Yes, I finally tried stationery from Instagram. Hello everyone and welcome to my haul and review of stationery items I recently got from Instagram. So I actually asked all of you which brands did you want me to review, and I reached out to those brands and asked them to send in a package which represented their brand the best. Now I'd like to give you an overview of what I love and what I hate on shopping for stationery on Instagram. What I love is that there is no tamjham of going through the whole website. There is one feed which will have all the products and the aesthetics of the brand. So in one go, I can go through everything that the brand has to offer to me as an experience and the products. Another thing that I love is brands are really good with DMs on Instagram. They are very quick, they're very responsive, and it's way easier to talk over DMs than on emails. Now the things that I dislike is that most brands do not display their price. I'm sure they have their own strategy for this. But when I want to decide whether I want to buy a product or not, I would like to see the price directly rather than asking on DMs how much it is for. Another thing I dislike is that even though the comment section is more ready for reviews, I don't see that many reviews by customers. So I know it is very difficult to review products otherwise on e-commerce websites, because then you have to give your stars and you have to write a whole paragraph. But in the comment section, you could literally write it very quickly. I hope brands find a way to encourage customers to give reviews under their products on Instagram. Now let's get into the details and go brand wise. The first brand we're going to review is Paper Jam. Now I actually came across them in the Little Flea in April this year itself. I did not manage to go for the November one, but I do think that they were there. The very first things from Paper Jam are these greeting cards. Right off the bat, the first thing that I love are that they are square. Now there's also the Indian touch in this card which says you are the best, and instead of best there's the BEST bus. So I like such desi tadkas on stationery. Now the actual finish is quite glossy, so I decided to skip using a gel pen or a ball pen, because usually when you're writing cards on a glossy paper, those pens tend to spread. So I directly did the marker test and the marker did not spread at all. It dried up very quickly in just 5 seconds. The next thing by Paper Jam is this blank notebook. I'm emphasizing on blank because I love blank notebooks. They are so free. You can draw, write, scribble, whatever you want. And this one I love a lot because the fox is sitting on the yoga mat and it says breathe in, breathe out. I do think that this is again an Indian tadka because yoga is native to India. I did do a gel pen test and it did appear on the next page. For this particular notebook, a ball pen or a pencil would be the best fit. Now one very unique thing I found on Paper Jam was this habit tracker. Very simple. Has the month or the week section if you want to write that, and you just have to write in the habit that you want here. For example, I want to work out and study and edit videos every single day, and then I just have to tick out cross mark it. I did the ball pen test, the gel pen test and the marker test, and all three of them did not bleed onto the next paper, which was great. This is a simple tear off notepad. Once you're done with that particular week or month, you can definitely rip it off and start afresh. But what if you want to keep all the pages and see how good you've been throughout the year? Then you have this small little file which is so adorable. It has a lion picking up the weights and it comes with papers inside. So this is like a binder. You have to open it and you can put in your papers and then close it, and there you have your pretty little binder or file. I love this because I have not seen this size of a binder or a file. About the papers that come inside with it, I did the gel pen test because I usually use this particular pen all the time, and it did not bleed on even to the back side of the paper, so both sides are usable and legible easily. And the last thing from Paper Jam is this personalized diary. You can customize your name here or your company's name here, and then you can put in quotes. So my quote is, making family the most positive and comfortable place, redefining the internet. When you open this, you have a full polka dot page, and then as soon as you turn the polka dot page, the normal pages start. So there's no ribbon bookmark. In case of someone who does not like to use those bookmarks, then this diary does not come with that, which is perfect for you. And my top two products from Paper Jam are the habit tracker and the tiny binder. Now the next brand we're going to try is the Stationery Freaks. The name totally describes what they stand for. When I found them, they were at 150 followers on Instagram, and for that kind of numbering, the kind of products that they have is crazy because they have a huge variety, and I'm impressed with most of the products. And my first thought was that this is so much better than buying stationery from those Chinese websites, because on those websites, I do not get the option of buying a single pen or a single pencil. But on their page, it is actually possible to buy even a single piece of a cute sticky note or an individual pen if you want. So as I shared, the first thing that caught my attention are the individual sticky notes. I've never seen a brand actually sell sticky notes individually like this. The only thing I'm unsure about is the strength of the glue. Now, it did stick very well in my planner, but I don't know how it would stand alone on a loose page. The next thing that really caught my eye on their page are the individual pens. How cute are they? You have a scented ice cream sundae pen. However, you do have to remember that the ink is not scented, which I don't mind actually. Another unique pen on their page was this light up pen. I did try to find if you could replace the batteries, but I could not find it from where you could do that. They also have an ice cream sundae pen, a bright orange pen with a rabbit on it. Then they have a unicorn one. They have a cat one. One thing that I really loved about the Stationery Freaks pens is that they are blue in color. Most of the pens that I've ordered off of Chinese websites, they are always black. So my mom keeps complaining that how will I write checks with this, and some places I don't want to use a black pen. So most of the pens by them were blue in color. And this emoji pen actually comes with an emoji notebook of the same emoji. And I did the pen test with this. Ink does not bleed onto the back of the page or onto the next page. So it's great quality paper as well. They also have a good variety of highlighters, because I found this injection highlighter. How I wish that you could actually press the injection and it would come out, but it's not like that. You just have a plastic cap in the front which you have to take out and put back on, but the design is still so pretty good. They also have a little highlighter which looked like an eraser to me in the first place, but it's a very mini and cute highlighter. The injection highlighter is not very consistent when you're actually highlighting, but when it goes for the bottle highlighter, it is very, very consistent. And so is the last highlighter, which is floral in color and has a stamp in the front. The Stationery Freaks had such good paper clips as well, because these are much more huge than a normal size paper clip, and they have cute accents on the top which are color coordinated, so it becomes very, very easy to put them on paper, and it does not really rip my paper off when I'm trying to take it out. The only miss I had for them were their notebook erasers. They look adorable and would look great on a desk, but they do not really function. I tried the blue eraser and it actually stained the white paper and did not erase what I had written. Now they have a Lego sharpener, so you can sharpen your pencil, and then you have to slide open the door at the back, and then you can throw the waste away. The back is slightly tough, but once you get the hang of it, you will be fine. They also sent in a bunch of notebooks. So the first one is a plain black one with golden accents. This golden accent is just a foil print and it is not 3D. However, the sides are also painted golden. The next notebook they sent is a magnetic planner. And again, what I love about this is that the sides are also of the same print as the notebook. I have not seen that anywhere else, so I love that. The last product by the Stationery Freaks is this planner, and this is the most favorite thing I've received by them, because the inside is also colorful. But what I love more than that, this has a monthly and weekly planner and a notes section. So the first few pages are for the monthly plans where I can note down my appointments. Then I have an in-depth weekly planner, and then in the end I have place to make notes. And it still has little colorful candy prints. So my top two products from the Stationery Freaks are the paper clips and the monthly, weekly and notes planner. Now we move on to the Candy Call store. So we're gonna start off with this pretty postcard, and the print on this is actually 3D. I'm so damn tempted to put this up on my Jute board, but I'm going to save this for a giveaway. They also have this little greeting card to give to your bridesman, and it is pre-printed with a message. So I love that now you have brands except Archie's as well, because competition encourages more variety for us. But the highlight from them to me were these notebooks. The first one is similar to one we already saw. It is plain black and golden, but this one is 3D, and I think the number of pages in this are more. Another difference is that the one we saw previously was ruled and this one is completely blank. So it totally depends on your preference. And I'm going to announce this in advance. My top two from the Candy Cal store are these two notebooks, because these are so desi and so quirky. The first one says Blogger Rani and the other one says Proper Patola. Love the print, the color and the quality. So every product that I've seen from the Candy Cal store, I do love, and I can see that a lot of effort has gone behind it, and I cannot wait for them to launch more products. And the last one is Supple Room. Now Supple Room has their own aesthetic. We're going to start off with their pencils. Each pencil reads Follow Your Dreams. I'd also like to point out that the packaging had rose gold stapler pins, and that again adds to their brand aesthetic and their brand feel, and I love that. Now these pencils retail for $199. That comes down to almost 50 rupees for one pencil. And I realized why that was the moment I started sharpening the pencil. Because when I was sharpening, I did not hear the khar khar khar. And I'm like, my sharpener is blunt because I don't hear any noise. But the moment I pulled out the pencil, it was sharpened and it's so damn smooth. So I'm sure the material has something different and something unique, because the pencil is extremely smooth, not only to touch and feel, but also to write. But one thing I'd like to point out is that the eraser at the back works effectively only if you have not applied pressure while writing. The next thing by them are these flamingo pens, and the necks are bendable. They did require a bit of warming up in the beginning, but once the warm up was done, they worked very smooth. The last writing tool I received by them is this rose gold pen, which has a diamond on the top. This to me feels very luxurious because you have to roll it to bring the nib out, and then when you put it back in, and the whole feel of it. So I do think they're appealing to somebody more of my age who is able to take care of such a nice pen, because this retails for $325. This is actually the only ball pen I received, so if you prefer that, then this is the one for you. The next thing by them are these marble sticky notes. How adorable. What I love about them is the quantity and how strong the glue is. I used their own flamingo pen and it did not bleed at the back. In my opinion, one of the signature products I found on their Instagram page were these paper clips. I love them. They have the pastel arrow ones and the rose gold ones. The edges are very neat and they did not tear my paper off. My personal favorite is the camera one in rose gold. Any surprises? The next things are these planners. The first one is a to-do list. The finishing on the side is glossy, so I assume that the paper will also be glossy, but it isn't. It is slightly rough, which is good because that'll help the pen to dry out faster and has a lot of space for writing, yet it is aesthetic. And this A5 planner is completely glossy except the white part. So I was concerned that I don't think this will work well with ball pens or gel pens. So even though it was slightly difficult to work with a ball pen, it dried completely. When I did the smudge test, it did not smudge. Neither did the gel pen, and the marker, as we expected, it wouldn't have smudged. And it's very organized. The second last thing for this video is this little spiral bound notebook which says be your own inspiration. It also has hearts doodled out at the back, and from the inside it's blank. How I love myself a blank spiral bound notebook. And the last thing for this haul are these stickers which say it's my life stickers. Now these are the prettiest planner stickers I've come across, because the quantity is a lot, and at the same time they make sense, like work, study, bill due today, monthly goals, priority, and these do reflect the color scheme that Supple Room shows as their brand aesthetic. So my top two products from the Supple Room are these paper clips and this A5 planner. So the purpose for me to make this video was to show you the actual picture of what you see on Instagram and what you will end up getting and how the products actually perform, because that's always on our mind. Will the paper be thick enough? What kind of pen can I use with this? How will it look in natural lighting? So I hope I could cover all these aspects for you, because as a customer, these are my first doubts. A big thank you to all these brands for sending these products in. I don't think it would have been possible for me to purchase so many products in one go. So thank you so much. I will link the Instagram of all these brands down below in case you want to shop from them. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give this a thumbs up and let me know down below what other brands do you want me to review. Coming to the exciting part, the stationery giveaway. I'll be posting this picture on my Instagram, and these are all the things that the giveaway winner will win. All that I have to do to participate is subscribe to this channel, follow me on Instagram, and tag 5 friends of yours in that post. I will be announcing the winner within 1 week. I wish you all the very best. Until then, goodbye!